Hello again. It is July 24th. It's about 11 o'clock in the morning, and I'm mostly done with work for the day. I'm working on a weekend. Kind of forgot that I pick up this shift, and there was a lot of fun stuff going on this weekend I had to bow out of because of work this morning. Just a couple of visits. And I got all of my homework done. I know I haven't posted a video in a few days. But that was because I was doing a bunch of admissions, which had a lot of paperwork, and then I had my big term project due, the written part of it, due on Friday. And, of course, I put it off until the last minute, and I was, like, working on it furiously Friday night. But it's all done now, and I can't say it, like, really reflects exactly what I'm going to be doing next week or the week after, when I actually do this teaching project on ethical considerations of end-of-life care, but I did a pretty good academic write-up of, you know, like, mostly what I'll be doing. I hope my evaluation method flies. For my method of evaluation of the learning activity, I'm going to make an audio recording of our discussion and use the things that people say as proof that they're thinking about the material and applying their critical thinking skills and responding to case studies and stuff like that. And one of the attachables I had to submit along with the assignment was a sample of the handouts I'm going to be giving, and I couldn't get my scanner to work, so I took a picture of one of the articles with my cell phone, you know, with like my hand holding it or whatever. You can kind of make out like some of the stuff on there, but it's really just like a digital camera picture of me holding a sheet of paper with words on it. I hope that'll fly. I'm not really, like, all that concerned about it because, I mean, I haven't, like, exactly been doing, like, the most work on it that I could be doing, and I'm still getting 95% on everything, so, not that big a deal. I am looking forward to doing the actual teaching project, even though I haven't quite gotten a totally complete mental model in my head of how I'm going to go about doing it, because so much is going to depend on, like, the people who are there, like, their body language, their facial expressions. I just want to, like, collect a good amount of resources and then kind of feel my way through as best as I can. With only half an hour, it's going to be tough, but I'll try to make it a fun half hour for all the nurses and social workers there. So I did another nursing home visit today, and I did a home visit, and I'm going to do another quick home visit on my way home, and mainly catching up with people I've seen before, so that's kind of nice, you know, get to kind of see the results of the suggestions that you've made in the past, and it's really nice to see everybody just being really well-adjusted and well-supported and coping really well, you know, and having visits with the social workers and really, like, displaying that they understand what's going on and everything is happening the way they expect and stuff, and it's a pretty good, easy day. I'm gonna be done by like, before noon probably. And then I think I'm off for a few days, which would be nice. I wish I could have been off like today and then like worked like the next couple of days because of all the fun like pool parties and, you know, rock shows and stuff that was going on yesterday, but that's alright. Really, when it came down to it, all I wanted to do was relax in the air conditioning anyway, so I got my air conditioner up now, and that's fantastic. I ordered a new bed, too, because my $2,500 12-inch Tempur-Pedic memory foam mattress, the cat peed on it, and when I first got that mattress years ago, the guy selling it to me said, you know, you should really get a mattress pad to protect your mattress, you know, because it costs a lot of money, and I'm like, mattress pads. It's gonna, like, ruin how the foam feels, you know, it's gonna make it so I can't really feel this expensive memory foam that I'm paying all this money for. And, you know, a few years later, the mattress is ruined, it's got cat pee all over it. I tried soaking it out with chemicals and stripping the mattress down and tried everything I could think of for a couple of weeks, and it's a loss. So, I walked into a furniture store a couple of days ago, and, I was on the lookout for whatever the latest and greatest thing is in mattresses since the 12-inch Tempur foam memory foam mattress. And apparently Simmons makes something now that's like priced to compete with the upper end of the new Tempur foam mattresses, where they got the gel in it. So this is one for like $2,000 that has the gel in it, so it's cheaper than the Tempur-Foam mattresses, and it's like a newer, more novel mattress technology, and that's really what I'm looking for when I go and make any kind of large purchase, or even any kind of small purchase. I want to make sure it's like, you know, cutting edge, top of the line. It should be something in itself that's worth telling a story about because it's so amazing, and that is what I've achieved. So, I'm halfway through transition to practice, my first like actual honest to goodness nursing class in my new course of study, going for that master's degree, and it hasn't really been that difficult so far. I still just feel like I'm jumping through hoops mostly, you know, like gotta tap out this little position paper and like, you know, prove that you know how to look things up. And the next one looks like it'll be a little more interesting. It involves health assessment techniques, and as part of that, I'm going to have to record a video of me performing a health assessment. So that should be fun. I don't know who I'm going to rope into that, but I'm sure I'll find somebody who will let me look in their ears with the otoscope and the ophthalmoscope. And you know, I bought an otoscope and an ophthalmoscope when I was a new nursing student. I'd just gotten into nursing school, just gotten accepted, and they had the big fundraiser at the beginning of the semester where you buy your stethoscopes and your blood pressure cuffs and stuff like that. And I went, you know, as I tend to do, I went like all out and I spent hundreds and hundreds of dollars. And although the stethoscope I did use for many years until it died on me, the otoscope and the ophthalmoscope that I paid like $300 for, the two of them, the diagnostic kit, never used it. Never used it once. It has not been used at all. I've never used it. I've used the otoscope and ophthalmoscope at the nursing home that I worked at, but that wasn't like the kind of thing where I'd bring my own gear in from home. So I've got these things in my room somewhere. Hopefully I'll be able to find them, but I am going to need them for the next class. Let's see, what else is going on? I had a lot of admissions over the last couple of days, and I did an evaluation for a general inpatient admission, which was kind of interesting. I don't get to do those that often, because general inpatient status is like a higher level of care that's for people who have symptoms that are hard to control, and I got called out to evaluate somebody to see if they qualified, and when I looked over the documentation, everybody had documented that what they were doing was working just fine, so I had to say no, you know. You don't qualify if the things that people are doing are working okay, you know. So this is why, you know, like accurate nursing documentation is really important, because, you know, somebody might say one thing, like, oh, this anxiety is out of control, and then you go look at the nurse's notes that they wrote, and it says, they had anxiety, but we got it under control, you know. I think there might be a little bias in like routine charting, where people might be a little bit afraid to document that they failed, that they weren't able to get the symptoms under control, and that's a shame, because we rely on that documentation when we're, you know, looking for ways to improve things or trying to see if people qualify for this benefit or the other benefit. And it's a little bit like detective work. I'm glad I worked in a nursing home before, because I can look through all that stuff and really sort of put together a mental model of what this person's life has been like in the nursing home for the last, you know, week or the last 2 weeks or however far back the notes go. And I learned how to do a really good chart audit at the nursing home that I worked at from working with this overnight nurse. And she doesn't work there anymore. She moved on to another facility. But she taught me how to do a really, really good chart audit. And the first time she showed me how to do it, I was bored stupid. Like, 5 minutes later after we started, I'm like, can I get up and do something else now? I really don't want to audit charts anymore. Can I please, please, please do something else now? And, but then when it was me, and there was a stack of 20 charts to audit for flip night, I did exactly what she taught me. I went through it all systematically, line by line, took my time, opened everything and flipped everything open in the order she showed me and everything. And I really got into it by the third or fourth chart. It was actually pretty interesting, because it is a lot like detective work. You really have to, you know, use your critical thinking and understand what you're looking at and put all the pieces together. And I have a hard time reading handwriting, but it's easier when you know what you're looking for already and you've got other things to compare it to, you know? But I want to do everything I can to reduce the amount of time I spend puzzling over paperwork. It would be so much easier if we had, you know, like a computerized summary of all of this stuff, but yeah, you gotta walk around and flip open your little books and then papers go flying everywhere and stuff like that, but that's okay. I'm glad I learned how to do it the old-fashioned way, so whatever comes next fails, I'll know how to go back. Well, that's it. That was my weekend, and I hope you all had a good weekend, and if not, tough luck.